I'm still here.
You can still have it turned on though. Hey everybody, good afternoon, good morning, good evening. Try it again. How's everybody doing? It's Monday night, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, so that's why we do Q&A. Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. And just...
Hey you guys, how's it going? What's going on today? Everyone having good weather where they are? We're having some cool raininess. Kind of done with it.
Yeah,
sure. I got my jacket on and everything.
It's really cold out.
I feel like I had to put my snowsuit on. This is my snowsuit.
It is.
Uggs and a fuzzy jacket.
I'm just trying to set up a piece of software here. Guys, just hold on 1 second.
I think we got it.
Nope.
Nope. Uh-oh.
Keep talking.
Do this. Yeah. All right. Hey, how's it going? What's up?
Here we go.
Oh, yay.
All right, here we go.
Hey, BJ.
Okay, here we go.
Hey,
let's
Argentina.
Get started. Hey, Argentina, how are you doing? Okay, great. All right, here we go. Let's start. So if you don't know who I am, my name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. I always have to take it. We have to start the software after I start my Periscope in order to capture all of the questions so we don't lose them all. That way we can get back to them. If you don't know who I am, my name is Jeff Gellman. I'm from Solid Canine Training. I'm up in Providence, Rhode Island. I've got a dog training company up there. I personally travel the world doing dog training seminars. You can go to rvdogtrainer.com, rvdogtrainer.com, and you can see the work that I do around the world, and we're balanced dog trainers. Got a great, awesome staff of 9 people. And what does a balanced dog trainer mean? I believe in yes and no. It's as simple as that. I'm not going to talk science to you. I'm going to talk just real world, how to stop a dog from doing what you don't want to do and how to get a dog to do what you do want to do. And if you want to get a dog that wants, I'm trying to educate the public on dog training. So if you want a dog to do something more, you reward it. How do you reward it? Food, praise, toy, physical touch. So those are great rewards. If you don't want the dog to do something, or if you want the dog to stop doing something, you have to use punishment. Punishment is not abuse. Punishment is just don't do that anymore. How do you do that? You do that through a correction. So I've got a great video on punishment on my YouTube channel about proper punishment. You're not mad. You're not angry. You're not yelling and screaming. You're just disagreeing with the dog that was wrong. You're letting them know. Next. Here we go.
Came across a reactive dog today. Owner let it pull my... I don't know what, ignored it, and we kept going thanks to you.
Awesome, proud of you, that's fantastic.
Eye drops meds for very uncooperative terriers, same as nail trim protocol?
Yeah, you can, what you can do is, you could do the nail trim protocol, but you wanna do that is for, if your dog is fighting you to get the nail, the eye drops in, or if they're growling, you can punish the arousal, and then you could reward successful eye drop. Putting in. So you can use it a combination of a bonker. A bonker is a towel wrapped up. The dog is going, oh my God, I don't want to do this. Bonk. There goes the arousal. And then every time you get a successful eye drop in, click and treat. You can do that. So remember, it's really important that people understand people, you know, a lot of people say, oh, well, if you punish or correct the dog when it doesn't want to do something, it won't want to do it. No, it doesn't want to do it already. It's called imagined harm. You know what I mean? It's called imaginary harm. It's just like, it doesn't work that way. Your dog will be fine. Why? Because we do it all the time. Next.
How do you feel about bedding in a kennel?
Oh, I can care less. As long as the dog doesn't destroy it. If the dog destroys it, no bedding. I can care less. You can have bedding, you can have toys, you can have a monogram bedding. I'm being serious. But if your dog destroys the bedding, you have to get rid of it because your dog could die. Your dog could die. Toys, I don't care. But I don't use toys in kennels to stop separation anxiety or to keep the dog busy. When a dog's in a kennel, I actually want them to do nothing. I'm not against the dog playing with toys. I'm not against bedding, but what's the behavior of the dog? So, you know, if the dog continues to rip up the bedding, dogs ingest that stuff. So I don't care at all. That's fine with me. And it could be a cheap towel or the most expensive, you know, bed you can find. Doesn't matter to me. Next.
Dog doesn't always respond to the e-collar. What to do? Thanks, Jeff.
Cass, I don't know what brand of e-collar you're using. I don't know if you've got a fit on right. I don't know what levels you're using. So, you know, dogs don't respond to a lot of stuff if the dog is, you know, aroused. So if the dog is in a state of arousal, your levels have to go up. So I've got no idea what brand it is, if it's fit correct. I don't know any of that stuff. So if the bottom line is, if it doesn't respond to it, if it doesn't respond to it, that means it's either not powerful enough remote collar, or it's not turned on, which has actually happened, or you're not using it properly. So any of those things. But all dogs will respond to a remote collar if it's powerful enough. Next.
Can I pay for overnight shipping for an e-collar from you?
We don't do overnight shipping. We're in a very small operation. You're better off going to ecollar.com, buying from them direct. Just buy right from them direct. They're set up for all that stuff. We're not. It would go out just priority mail. We can flag it expedited mail, but if the mailman doesn't come to pick it up, and we're not going to run down to the post office. We just don't have the people power to do stuff like that. We just leave it out for the mailman to pick up. So I would just go to thanks for wanting to buy from me. Thank you so much. But just go to ecollar.com. Talk to them tomorrow. Next.
My dog eats poop on occasion. Besides being gross, is it dangerous?
Well, it's extremely dangerous. Your dog can actually die. Your dog actually can die because there's parasites in there that can kill your dog. So, and then there's also, or at a minimum, your dog can get very sick. At an even minimum, your dog could throw it all up in your house or while you're driving in your vehicle. So that's disgusting. That you want to do that. How do you stop a dog from eating poop? Whether it's, you know, dogs eat dirty diapers from humans, then they eat dog poop, then they eat all the different animal poop out there. All that is fixed with a remote collar. Is fixed with a remote collar. What do? Remote collar on the dog at the highest setting. The dog goes to eat the poop. You correct. You make it super uncomfortable. So a lot of times people will say, oh, so you use pain to train dogs? Not with obedience, we don't. But to stop eating poop, of course we do. The dog loves eating poop. You know, the dog loves eating poop. Of course you would make it uncomfortable. Why wouldn't you? What am I going to do? Praise the dog for not eating poop? What happens when the dog does eat poop? So a little bit of common sense, is in order here. Next.
Place correction. How high should it be?
Depends on how, you know, those are just numbers. So you could have a dog that corrects at 8 and it's like the end of the life. You have a dog that corrects at 88. Don't worry about numbers on a remote. Pay attention to the dog. You know what I mean? I wouldn't know. I wouldn't know what number. I would have no idea at all. I'm not working the dog. So work the dog in front of you. If the dog knows the command, if you've been working on, say, the place command for a couple of weeks, the dog absolutely knows what it is. And when you say no, the dog actually goes back. Now, what would happen is if the dog keeps breaking, it's time to actually start really punishing the dog. And when we say punishment, guys, it's not abuse. You know, I don't talk science, but people love to talk science. Punishment is part of science. That's fact. It's actually 50% of the science, but we're not going to go there. But punishment just means don't do that anymore. That's all. Next.
Is the eye contact thing really important? My trainer really drills it in.
Megan, it's not. It's always good. This is the thing. If you've got a good connection with your dog's probably going to be looking at you. You could work on it. It's nice to have because then your dog is focusing on you instead of other things, but it's not like it's mandatory, but it's nice to have. Next.
6 month Roddy starting teen years or fear period, nervous barking at random things. And when he wants
something probably. Yeah. So Alex, so all barking is fixed with a correction, punishment. So bark, remote collar, stim, bonker, leash pop, you know, take any one of those. All right, hold on. What's going on here with YouTube? Hey, YouTube, how are you? Love you. Thank you, Joshua, so much. Love you too, buddy. How realistic for a 10-week-old puppy to not rush the door after being made to sit? A 10-week-old puppy? You have a 10-week-old puppy. 10 weeks old. It doesn't know anything yet. So with your 10-week-old puppy, it's all food protocols. It don't worry about it rushing the door right now. But the fact that you're making it sit, awesome. Next. It's a 10-week-old puppy.
Hi, guys. Great as always. Not long now, Jeff, till you come to God's country.
Can't wait. I'll be there soon. I'm sure you're talking about Scotland. Next.
Something jealous of my wife when I hug her. I don't get it.
All right. Yep.
Puppy that is 8 months old visiting was a bit too much for my 2-year-old dog. She snapped. Should I correct?
No, you shouldn't actually. If you should advocate for your dog. So right now, here we go. Two dogs in place. So here's a great example. If I had a young puppy getting in their face right now, if my dogs don't correct it, I will. Take your pick, puppy. Who you want to play with, me or them? Let's go. Next.
Also, just amazing content and very helpful.
Oh, Alex, thank you.
Lucy says thank you.
You're welcome, Lucy.
Working on play off leash using remote, but no prong. Now they are much calmer and chill together.
Awesome. Yeah, Donna, don't ever have a prong collar on a dog when it's playing with another dog, because they can get intertwined. Next.
Dog doing well, but still looks at strangers on walks like he's scared and slightly growls. What would you do?
I would actually correct that. I would punish that because, you know, I don't even want the dog growling. And a lot of times people will say, no, if you punish the growling, they'll just go and bite. No. Can you go figure that out? No, they won't. Or just tell the kids to do something. All right, thanks. What you can do is this. You could do is you'll not only punish the growling, you'll punish the thought of actually even lunging or barking or biting. So you can handle that all at once. You can handle it all at once. All right? Vomit is called shamit. Yep.
There's nothing I can do.
Okay, great.
He stopped.
Okay, good.
What's the best approach to manage rough housing so that it doesn't escalate, but we still have fun?
You know, Jay, that's up to you. It's all up to you. Like with my dogs, I let my dogs play rough, but they don't fight. So I let them play pretty rough. But also what I want to do is I want to also say enough and they stop immediately. So if you let them go up, you got to let them go down. You got to be able to turn them on, turn them off. There you go. Next.
Hey, Jeff, do you know if Sarge's Law applies to canine officers or service dogs?
Caroline, you know, I don't know. And Sarge's Law is the thing in Florida. But you know what, though? No disrespect to service dogs or canine officers, but that's what we really shouldn't be worrying about. That Sarge's Law is a law that's trying to be passed in Florida. And this is fact. You're not allowed to say no to your dog. Fact. And every dog trainer has to be licensed. And if you are a licensed dog trainer and you say no to a dog, you lose your license. Fact. That's the law. The thing about this is everybody's worried about canine officers. Trust me, I'm very close to a lot of different canines. Mad respect. But how many working canines are there in Florida? Seriously, probably what? 500. How many pet dogs are in Florida? 500,000 maybe. I'm more concerned, and again, no disrespect for service dogs either. I'm more concerned for pet dogs. Pet dogs. That is my number one concern, is pet dogs, because that's who is dramatically affected. Service dogs, obviously, I'm a concern, but you know, that's the thing. Next.
My GSD hates my brother-in-law. He did nothing to her. GSD turns back on him when he speaks to her.
Tim, you're humanizing your dog. Number one, we don't know if your GSD hates your brother. It doesn't make a difference whether your brother did or did nothing to the dog. The dog is turning its back on it. It's not like a human turning its back. It's not. You know what I mean? All it is is just your dog is not interested. I'd rather have that than your dog biting your brother-in-law. Do you know what I mean? I'd rather have that. So don't worry about it. Don't worry about it at all. And don't push it. Don't push it, because your dog is actually saying, I'm not interested. Respect it. Respect it. Next.
Thanks for the earlier Periscope about e-collars.
Oh, Albert, thank you so much. Thanks for the kudos. Next. Well, I'll be in Chicago, by the way, Albert, coming up. Next.
While walking my dog squeals and barks at other dogs and people, how do I stop this?
While walking my dog squeals and barks at other dogs and people. Oh, Scott, what a pain in the butt that is, huh? So first of all, Scott, this is the thing. You know, what are you doing with your walks? Like, what's the dog walking at? We don't have long enough time to talk about this, but I would recommend always, for starters, prong collar on the dog, 4 to 6 foot leash on the dog. Watch my video on prong collars. Watch my videos on getting the dog to walk next to you. always correct the dog, give information to the dog prior to the dog's arousal. Don't wait till the dog starts ramping up. Once the dog starts ramping up, you're doing something called chasing. Now all you're doing is you're chasing behind the growling, you're chasing behind the screaming, chasing behind the squealing. Instead, you want to squash it. Kaboom. You don't want that anymore. Lene, thank you so much for sharing it, which reminds me, if you're not following me, any people can follow me, and also feel free to share this on all your different social media platforms. That'd be really, really fantastic. Next.
I've sat the trainer. My German Shepherd is less reactive, calmer, and nicer.
Nick, you know what? It would be great if I didn't have a if I didn't have to have a dog training facility. It'd be great if I was put out of work. I'm not gonna be. I got job security. That's why I put out so much free information. No matter how much free information I put out, no matter how many seminars are around the world that I do, no matter how many Facebook posts I do, I got 10,000 hours of audio stuff. There's always going to be people that need help. And I appreciate that and I love that. But you can train your dog yourself. And that's what I want people to do. Because I don't want people to have a miserable life and I don't want people to be giving up their dogs and killing them. But number one, people think I must love dogs. Don't get me wrong, I do. But I love the human race way more. I can't stand humans in pain. Badly behaved dogs make humans miserable. I don't want that anymore. That's my goal, for humans to be happy. Better trained dogs make humans happy. That's my end. That's my end. Next.
Thanks, Jeff. She fights it a lot, and I think it's doing more harm than good. It's the eye contact question from Megan.
So, Megan, this is the thing. You know what I mean? Megan, you're working with a trainer. The last thing you want to do is this. You know, well, Jeff said don't do this. Like, no dog trainer wants to be like Jeffed. Like, well, go freaking hire Jeff then. You know what I mean? That's really sad, G Slice. That's really sad.
Yeah.
That's really sad. Okay. So this.
I think you just made something up. No one wants to be Jeffed.
Okay, whatever. Okay. So what I would do is this. Then don't do it. Then don't do it. Next.
Correction levels are like all over. My puppy needs 60 to 100 for correction, and my rough collie is 30.
It sure does. And different children, you know, and different children need different motivations to fix unwanted behaviors and to be motivated to do something good. Welcome to dog training. All right. Try to make sure you got a nice consistent fit on your tower. Next.
The bonker on top of crate for barking and going nuts has been a miracle.
Okay. There you go. That's why I make those damn bonker videos, and that's why I put up with the whole nonsense, because Kay can learn to do it. Kay can bonk the dog in the crate to shut it up, and Kay can write in to this show and saying that I've helped her all for free. That's why I'm doing what I'm doing. Good job, Kay. Next.
Crated dog more and more, like you suggest, had stopped her from going crazy. Thank you.
Good job, Kay. Proud of you. Fist bump.
What muzzle brands do you recommend? Baskerville size 4, too short on snout, size 5, way too big.
Ernesto, try the 4, put it in warm water, see if you can stretch it out a little bit. So get it in warm water, get the plastic to be a little bit more pliable, and then try to get it stretched out a little bit. That would probably be easier than making the 5 more compact. I would try that first. Next.
Dog ignored level 100 e-collar recall to run to a fence fight. Yep. Online now. Yep. Will the boss be better?
Yep. So what you're probably doing is you're probably on the mini educator, which is the lowest version. It's not comfortable, but I can put it on my neck at 100. It ain't comfortable. But if you put $1,000 in cash 50 feet away from me, all right, and you said that I'm going to put this on 100, and if you can get the $1,000, you keep it, guess what? I'm getting that $1,000. I'm going to scream the whole way, but I'm getting that $1,000. Why? Because the motivation for me to get that $1,000, I will deal with the discomfort of the remote collar. $10, I ain't moving an inch. No way. $1,000, I am. So your dog loves to fence fight. So your dog is going to fence fight. Why? It derives more pleasure from fence fighting than discomfort from level 100. So $100 to see that. Well, there's $1,000. Now I'm up to $1,100. You know what I mean? So I'd pay $100 to watch somebody do that too. I'm right in there with you, man. That'd be fun. So this is the thing. So you might need a boss, or what you do is you got to make sure you give that information to that dog way before. Next.
Should I start with prong before e-collar, or can I just start with e-collar?
It all depends on your leash handling skills, Desi. That's a really good question. If you've got really good leash handling skills, I would try to do leash and prong for a couple of days and then move to remote, but you can move right to remote if you want to. I think it's a lot easier to go with leash and not prong. Next.
What's a natural ingredient to prevent skin allergies for dogs like pit bulls?
I don't know, Eric. You know, I'm not a good holistic guy or like skin guy or nutrition guy or medical guy. What I would do is there's got to be a Facebook group out there that does like holistic remedies. In fact, somebody up here, I'm sure someone up here is going to know, but I don't want to turn this into that type of, chat type of thing, but there's got to be something out there. All I know is this, I feed my dogs the raw diet. It's dramatically helped. I deal with huskies all the time. I saw your question, Yo Young. We're going to get to it. We're a bunch of questions behind. Huskies are easier to train. Hold on. We'll get to you. Next.
If I have two dogs, should I plan to get the two-dog e-collar, or will I be mostly working them one-on-one?
Get the two-dog e-collar, but you can also get the one-dog e-collar, and you can order another collar and then add it to the system. Next.
I swear my dog thought her name was No when she was a
Yeah,
pup.
Sarah. Yep, exactly. Next.
What happens to a teacher who says no to a student?
I know. It's a ridiculous conversation. I know. It's silly.
Jeff, what's up? Just got home from our second successful dragging leash walk.
Awesome. Proud of you. Proud of you. Next.
When you say punish for growling, do you mean with e-collar? Puppy's growling is getting worse. Ugh.
Yep. Yeah, Megan. Yeah, you might not be going high enough. You know, you might not be going high enough. All right. So I'm going to get to everybody's questions. Guys, if it's your first time on the show, I get about 300 to 400 questions and they're on a computer here. So we keep track of them. We've actually gone on the computer. So please just be patient. You know, I'm trying to be as thorough as I can. I'll get to you. Don't worry. I'll get to you. Next.
Just bonked my dog for peeing in the house. Right or wrong?
If you caught your dog in the act, it's right. Next.
Hello, my dog first peed in the bathroom. Now he does it wherever he wants anyway to teach him.
To teach him, yeah, Dean, what I want you to do, Dean, is this. What's up with all the free roaming? You know what I mean? No free roaming with that dog. Eyes on that dog at all times. Know where your dog is. Crate your dog at night. Crate your dog when you're not home. You're going to have to catch your dog in the act, though, and you have to punish the dog. What's a punisher? A bonk or a rolled-up towel? You would say no. Throw it at the dog. Remote collar, stim. It's disgusting, as you know. That's why you asked the question. So let's hold back on all that free roaming. Next.
E-collar for correcting growling is lifesaver?
Yep, absolutely.
Do I have a chance at training my husky to not pull? She learns everything else but not this.
Yeah, so modernize. Yeah, what you're going to do is get yourself a prong collar. And watch my video, and you should have that eliminated in about 5 minutes. It takes about 5 minutes to stop your dog to 95% of dogs stop pulling in 5 minutes with proper leash handling and prong collar training. 5 minutes. Seriously. Next.
Bought a working spot for your San Diego seminar.
Oh, Colleen.
So
awesome. And she's talking about going to rvdogtrainer.com. In fact, I just announced Denver, Colorado today. Denver, Colorado.
Yep.
So this is not an ego brag. We're doing more dog training seminars around the world than any other dog trainer. Not an ego brag, but we're doing a ton of them. So, next.
He said prong would be too noisy and not work. Use prong for 3 months.
Prong too, I don't understand. No. Prong is too noisy. I don't know. Noisy. I don't know what that means. Next.
Me neither. For a dog aggressive dog, do you set the dog up to react in order to correctly punish it?
For life saving stuff, absolutely. Eating socks, getting in the trash, litter box, jumping on counters, stuff like that, absolutely. Next.
Jeff, LOL.
Yep, next.
I find my cattle dog.
Loose leash walk.
I'm not sure how to.
I find my cattle dog loose leash walk and sitting in front but not pulling. What do you think? Harrison, if you're cool with that, keep doing it. But I would do a 180 on that dog like in my video. Next.
Can huskies be trained not to pull and be off leash?
Yes, you can. So both, you can train a husky to be off leash trained with remote collar training and training and not to pull. All it boils down to proper dog training with the right philosophy, the right tools, and consistency. And it doesn't take forever. Yeah. Anybody that says that you can't get a husky to stop pulling doesn't have good dog training skills, in my opinion. And anybody that says that a husky can't be trusted off leash, they can't train a husky to be off leash. That's what it means. They can't do it. But if somebody's doing it, why can't it doing it? Up until 1956 or 1957, nobody ran a 4-minute mile. They said it couldn't. They said it couldn't be done until Roger Bannister did it, and now over 10,000 people have done it. It's up until 1956, beginning of time to 1956, running a 4-minute mile was not possible. Now one guy does it, Roger Bannister. Now 10,000 people can do it. What's up with that? So next.
You've helped me a ton, Jeff.
Oh, Greg, thank you.
My wife and I are having an issue with our two male mutts lunging at other dogs when both walk at the same time.
So what I would do is to walk one at a time, get a really good heel out of them, and then walk two at a time. And then also what I want you to do is those dogs should be on remote collar heeling. But and as soon as they get aroused, correct. What people do is they start seeing the dog all of a sudden, the ears go up, boom, correct. Chest goes out, correct. Going from this, correct. Any slightness of arousal, correct. You can use a bonker. Take a bonker. A bonker is a wrapped-up towel. Look, you know, Google Gary Wilkes. He'll be in Providence doing a seminar this weekend. It's a towel. You would say no, boom, throw the towel at the dog's head. People struggle with that because they think you're hitting the dog. It's a freaking towel. Get over it. You know, how many of us haven't, like, you know, hit our dog with a pool noodle before? What's the big freaking deal? And then the dog goes, whoa, I guess I better pay attention to my owner. Not afraid of my owner, but pay attention to my owner instead of, like, all the other nonsense going on out there. Next.
When I start training, I'm going to use that. Don't make me Jeff Gellman you.
Feel free.
It's a thing now.
All right.
How do you fix lunging issues in two adult males, only at other dogs being walked hiking?
It's you know, the same way is just train your dog to walk politely next to you. And as soon as that dog gets into a state of arousal, you would, boom, give it information. Give it information. So role play it over and over and over again when you're not hiking. That's for sure. Because the last thing you need is a lunging dog on a hike. Used to be a big backpacker, took my dogs off leash. So I know this really, you know, I had really good trail etiquette with my dogs. A lot of people didn't. So I had to over etiquette with my dogs. So let's make sure that dogs don't do that. Also, it'd be nice to have your dogs, you know, off leash for hiking because, boy, is that a great way to explore the wilderness. Next.
Great client's dog wanted to know if the boss would be a better model.
Yeah, the boss is always a great model, but I would try it without the boss first. I would try to set it up the dog and get the dog pre-fence fighting. A lot of fence fighting dogs, though, need the boss. Next.
The collar was on correct. Just depends on how excited he is.
Right. So, Harrison, you might have to go up a level, to a more powerful unit. Next.
Just wanted to say e-collar and prong has helped a lot. Jeff, couldn't have done it without you. Thanks.
Christian, my pleasure. You're the one doing the hard work. I'm just the guy with the big mouth getting out correct information that we've done thousands of times. I think that's important. Next.
Very excited and defiant dog kenneled outside. Suggested indoor kennel. Does it make a difference?
Well, Ruthie, I've got no problem. First of all, I've got no problem with outside dogs. I know a lot of people freak out about, oh, my God, my dog, the dog's outside. I own an outside dog. I've done a Periscope about my outside dog. You know, my outside dog's had a great life. It was just swimming. It went swimming 3 times today. It's around my dogs, around my kids. It just lives outside. That's why Linda had to step out because the dog was alerting to somebody on the property. So we had to just go see what was going on. And there was our guests that are here for our Airbnb. We're probably pulling in, and we just had to make sure everything was okay. So I got no problem with that at all. But as far as, like, if your dog is outside kenneled, because of its behavior, you can get it, you know, you can get it to be inside with just, I don't understand why you want the, what the question is maybe. Next.
I'll get a boss for dogs like this. Thanks, Jeff. Never used a boss before, but it makes sense to me.
Yeah, just get a boss. It's no big deal. It's a 1 through 100. You'll get used to it. Next.
Are pit bulls natural aggressors or does it depend on the owner?
You know, this is the thing about pitties. You know, we work with a lot of pit bulls, and the thing about this is when people say they were trained to be that way, I've always had this statement saying, agreed. Most people are not training their dogs of any breed to be aggressive on purpose. But what they're doing is they're not stopping their dog from being aggressive. So therefore, they are training it to be aggressive. Does that make sense? So when your dog jumps up on you, no matter what the breed is, you can say, oh, I can say, well, you trained your dog to jump up on people. You say, no, I didn't. Yeah, you did, because you didn't stop the dog. therefore you gave it permission, therefore you trained it. So I think when it comes to aggression, I think all dogs can have a natural tendency to be aggressive. I think that from a very, very young age, I think that it's important that you eliminate aggression immediately. That's why I have no problem punishing an 8 or 10 or 12 week old dog for what is an aggressive behavior. But I really feel, and I live in a very urban neighborhood. So Linda and I are minorities where we live right now. There's a lot of young, you know, black men with pit bulls in this neighborhood. And everybody is going to assume that they're aggressive dogs. I, though, assume, whether I'm right or wrong, but just by working with thousands of dogs, is that that they're actually the opposite. And I'll tell you why. Ever since these dogs were young puppies, they've been hanging out with the owner and all his buddies. It's called socialization. Also, you'll see these dogs with their buddies' dogs. It's called socialization. I see these dogs hanging out on a sidewalk, chit-chatting. You know, the owners are chit-chatting, the dogs are hanging out, and I see cars going by with dogs barking out the window. These dogs just go, "You got the big mouth looking like a fool. Look at me. I'm sitting cool on the sidewalk." You know, I see other dogs walking by, and these little dogs are like pulling, and the pitties are just going, "You're looking like a fool. I'm standing here all chill. What's your deal?" So I think that there's this, it's a stereotype. It is an absolute stereotype. Now, I absolutely won't discount that dogs fight and that there's dog fighting. Of course there is. You know, there's also lots of things. But, I think that most dogs become aggressive, and I'm spending some time on this because I deal with aggression. Most dogs become aggressive because they were never told not to be. Fact. Next.
After dog knows certain act is always wrong, is it necessary to say no when correcting?
You should. Yeah, you should say no. Next.
Sticking to your techniques and advice had more calms with your my dog and paid nothing.
So you'll be getting better results with my information, right, and didn't have to pay for it. Cool. That's what I love about free advice. Next.
Use coconut oil for coats.
There you go. Okay, I put coconut oil in my dog's food. Next.
I'm stuck.
Okay. Go down.
But you missed a whole bunch.
Okay, well, you have to start here. We have to do a show.
Okay. My 16-pound dog endured a 100 correction on e-collar correction for crate rebellion. Is he neurotic?
So, you know, is the dog, you got to get rid of that. There we go. Now just be patient with you. Your dog's not neurotic. Your dog is probably just has got a high threshold. But also, number one, make sure it was on snug enough. But, you know, we've seen small breed dogs just go nuts. They don't care. They don't care. So, next.
You a fan of New York system wieners?
Not anymore. I've been sober for 27 years, 20, I don't even.
Don't look at me.
Over 25 years I've been sober. And back in the days when I used to do a lot of drinking and drugs, it was my food choice.
It's called your drunk food.
It's drunk food, but yeah. It's probably been about that long since I've been there. Next.
I like them. Jeff, I'm in San Francisco. You are a beast. Use your vids 60 days. Everyone asks if I'm a trainer.
All right, Ernesto. Kudos to you. Next.
I send them to your YouTube channel.
Awesome. Thank you, Ernesto. Thank you.
Pet Fooled on Netflix has tons of info on holistic remedies for dogs.
There you go. Thank you so much. You said that. Shelby, thank you. Next.
Any recommendations for affordable raw food? Most seems super expensive for a 100-pound dog.
You know, Delilah, what I would do is this. I would do a lot of investigating on the raw diet. Do your research. And I think if you go, like, there's a market right down the street from us. It's a great market. They've got a great butcher down there. And what I would do is, that's going to have to stop. You know, to tell the dogs, the girls to put the dogs
they
away.
They can't.
Okay. What you're going to do is, let's have them do some investigating as far as, like, you know, what to feed the dog, how much vegetable, how much yogurt, how much meat, and you can do all kinds of meat parts. It actually probably is not as expensive as you think. You know, is it going to be more expensive than like, you know, $25 for a 50-pound bag of food? You know, absolutely. You know, absolutely. So what I would do is I would just do some research on that. I buy a prepared raw food. It's absolutely going to be not the way for you to go, because it's definitely going to be more expensive. I don't like the two-dog remote, FYI, too hard to switch back and forth when you need to correct quickly. I just have one button on the black button on the first dog, the red button on the second dog. So you can try that. Working on a CG test, practicing with prong, not allowed to test, we'll have to use a flat collar. Suggests, yeah, you can. What I would do is try using a martingale collar, or what you can do is use a remote collar and train that dog and make sure that dog understands the word no really, really well. So you can do that. Make sure the dog understands yes, and make sure the dog understands no. Iowa for a class, nothing close to Iowa at all. I've got Illinois, Texas, Indiana, and Colorado. That's about as close as I'm gonna get. In Fergus, Canada, Fergus, Ontario. Upstate New York, nothing in upstate New York at all, Greg. A lot of people come here, upstate New York. How to stop leash pulling? Leash pulling is easy to stop. It takes 3 to 5 minutes. So, you know, all leash pulling is just go to my video on how to buy a prong collar, what size to do, how to introduce the prong collar to the dog, and how to start walking the dog. It takes 3 to 5 minutes. Prong collar training. It's really easy. The Denver seminar is it'll be up on RV Dog Trainer later. She's got to put it up there. It's on my Facebook page though. Go to my Facebook page and it'll be there. All right. Scroll down. Keep going.
Stop my shepherd from pulling on prong 3 minutes.
Yep. Next.
Is offering recall in one-on-one home session realistic? I'm successful with my two dogs. Just launched business.
Alex, it's harder to do, but it's absolutely realistic. It's just harder to do. What you can do is you can do it without the owner there, so you can do your work. You know what I mean? So you can do your work, and then what you can do is then pass that information off to the owner. Next.
House was broken into. Dog won't go in side yard now without a leash. I don't want her afraid.
So, Lene, what I would do, sorry that you got your house broken into. You know, Florida's a rough state. So what I would do is this is, I'm glad your dog is safe and you're safe. So your dog was just startled. What I would do is just bring your dog out and make sure it's no big deal. Don't make a big deal of it. If your dog likes to play games out there, do food training out there, turn it into something fun. Next.
Friend's dog was attacked by two dogs. She wants to keep her dog away from other dogs now. Good or bad?
TMB, it all depends on her skill.
No.
It all depends on her skill. Nine.
Sorry.
Okay. It all depends on her, skill. So that's it. But I would find socialization. I would find socialization, class. I wouldn't go to a dog park, but just find some good socialization. And also what I want you to do is next time dogs come running up to you, use your foot. People struggle with this concept, but use your foot hard. Do anything you can. I don't care if the owner's like, my dogs are friendly. I can't tell you how many times I've heard that, and then the dog attacks your dog. So there's no such thing. Next.
Pit bulls are very resilient, and when trained right, they will ignore everything. They are chill.
Yep, true, Shelby.
Ever seen someone train or own a wolf?
Yeah, I have. I don't suggest it. I know some wild animal trainers. I've seen some wolf hybrids that are pretty high up on the wolf scale. I don't suggest it. I just don't suggest people getting them. They're definitely not a family pet. Definitely not a family pet. Next.
You guys have helped me so much.
Oh, gosh. Thanks, Pinnacle.
Thank you very much for your info. Assured me to be able to train my dog with prong collar correctly.
Absolutely. Yep. Next.
Sober, rare word in Australia.
Yeah, well, it's even rarer in Russia. I used to do business in Russia, and I'd go over there for a trade show, and it's a trade show, opens up at 9 in the morning, you're trying to make a deal, and boom, the vodka comes out. It's not a stereotype.
It's drink first, it's business
just, yeah, so it's like, guys, I don't drink. I mean, my translator said that in Russian, and
you want to see
a bunch of, you know, not to be a stereotype, this is, you know, stereotype, and you want to see a bunch of, you know, Russian guys laughing at 9 in the morning. Come to Russia with me. So, next.
Feeding a good raw diet will save you lots of money in vet bills.
Yep, it's true. Next.
Sorry if I missed your answer on
top. Yep.
If we go on a structured walk, will people help with proper leash manners? Want to go, but I'm still...
So, this is it.
Still working with
yes.
the dog.
So, yes and no. So in other words, we have something called the Walk Doctor Program, which is one-on-one training with you and your dog helping with a walk. But you have to remember, I've got two staff members and I've got people walking. If you need a little bit of help, absolutely. If your dog is way out of control, it's probably not the walk for you, and you probably should do the Walk Doctor Program first. We'd love to have you there, but you also have to remember it's not even close to private training. It's just we're helping owners that practice balanced training empower their dogs and come together as a group. But you're welcome to do it, but it all depends on what's going on with your dog. All right, next.
Too much praise can be too exciting for some dogs during training. Can other rewards be counterproductive?
Yeah, the same thing with food. The same thing with food. Yeah. If I'm doing like task training, or I don't do sport dog training, but say I'm doing explosive training with Kira. I've got a dog that hits on 12 different explosive odors. I'm gonna praise her up like out of control when she finds bombs. It's like, it's incredible. But when it comes to stuff like, you know, sit, down, place, now I want things to be neutral. Next.
Am I using remote wrong? If it's on two, I don't know what it is. If
it's on two dog.
Two dog, then are both red and black buttons active?
Well, it's, yeah, technically, okay, I'm not sure what unit you have, but I don't have one up here with me. But if you want the second dog, historically, the red button is the second dog and the black button is the first dog. So if they're both receivers are on, but if you hit the second button, it triggers the second dog. Okay, next.
Do you ever make it out to the New York or New Jersey area?
Yeah, I go through New York all the time, but you're close to me. So you're local. You're local to me in Providence, Rhode Island. I've got a seminar coming up in Providence in September. So we get a ton of business. A lot of our board and train business comes from New York and New Jersey. So just go to, you know, solidcaninetraining.com and you can see where we are. Next.
There's software you can change the button layout.
Yeah, I'm the four dog. I'm the easy educator. Next. Yeah.
My wife is listening for the first time. She just said your YouTube was the best for leash pulling prong.
Hey, how good. Thanks, Mrs. Tim. Thank you.
You made me. Yeah. I don't know what that is. I think I missed the answer to correcting submissive peeing dog towards other dogs.
Well, I'm quite. If I saw that, Heather. No. So your dog submissive pees towards other dogs. Submissive peeing is hard. Submissive peeing is really, really hard to deal with. I'd rather deal with a biting dog, actually. So when your dog submissive pees towards other dogs, it's really, really challenging. Make sure you introduce them outside. You can keep the dog in motion. You can keep your dogs, keep the dog in motion, try to do a lot of walk-bys other dogs. It's really, really hard to deal with that. I would first also check out for a UTI. If the dog gets excited, that's not my specialty. It's really not my specialty. I think there's a lot of people out there that have got some really good. Okay, you're going too fast. Let it catch up. Oh, okay. Let it catch up, because that's a new comment. So I'm not quite sure.
Some up top there.
Okay. Okay. So something's going on. Okay. I have no good helpful hints for submissive peeing. Okay. Next. Stop right there. Yep.
Okay. Sorry, you guys.
Okay, yeah.
I've got a dog. She's 5 years old, very lazy, doesn't want to do anything. Any ideas?
Yeah, I mean, so I don't know if your dog's overweight. I don't know if your dog's got a medical issue at all. But get up and start with walks. Get up and start with walks. You know what I mean? So walk your dog. Start with that, then start doing basic training. Get your dog onto some agility equipment. You can turn nature into your natural agility class. I mean, I think if it's up to us to get our dogs out. Sometimes they just get complacent. Next. But check health. Check health too.
Dog takes a while to use the bathroom when I take him out. Any tips to speed it up?
Yeah, take the dog out. If it doesn't go to the bathroom in 30 seconds, put the dog back in, put it in a crate. No free roaming until you go to the bathroom. Next.
Frozen.
That's if the dog has to go to the bathroom. Do me a favor. Don't go back up anymore. Okay. Yeah. So.
Nervous dog in heat.
So we have software here that we're doing that's not the Periscope software. It's different software, and it's causing problems right now.
Can't do anything.
Yeah, okay.
You just have to sit
down. All right. So we're just going to sit here for wait a little bit. My name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. And you can go to rvdogtrainer.com to see my tour schedule. Press wait, not kill again. Wait. Okay. And we'll see what happens. Yep. We just got to see what happens to that. We've got a great Instagram channel. Check it out. Periscope. We did some great Periscope today. You're welcome, Greg. So yeah, we have software that keeps track of all the questions because you see how quick the questions disappear. And for some reason, it's it just froze up on us. Yeah. Gary Wilkes' seminar is going to be fantastic this weekend. Yep. It's going to be really, really great. Looking forward to it. Nine plots. They've got to go outside. Okay. Your dog knows left and right. Cool. Awesome. Yep. Yeah, you can teach your dog hundreds of things. Front, back, left, right, next.
Okay. I got nothing. There's no next.
Okay, cool.
Okay, here we go. A 6-month-old mini schnauzer stops suddenly every 10 feet while on prong collar outside, only on sidewalk.
So what I would do is, I got a feeling your dog is manipulating you. If you took the leash off of your don't do this, please, off your dog, I bet you would start running around like crazy. So I think your dog is just saying, F you, I'm not moving anymore. So what I've got a feeling is I want you to then do gentle leash pressure, and work the dog through it. Next.
Do you ever come to South Florida?
Yeah, I'm in Florida. I just bought a house in Florida. I was there the last 4 days. I closed down the house and put some pictures up on Facebook, and then I was there getting it all ready to be rented out. I do a seminar in Ellington, Florida. So maybe probably not as south as you want me to, but I do two seminars in Ellington, Florida. If you go to rvdogtrainer.com, and it's worth the drive. So wherever you are, even if you're in Key West, people come from Key West, so they can't get much souther than Key West. So, more south than Key West. So they come to the Ellington seminar next, and you go to, that's in January and February next. So. It's frozen.
There
we go. Yep. And don't go up at all.
Have you done a video of training a deaf dog? Would that be a good free Skype topic?
You could if you want to. So
no.
Okay. So what you can do is we trained maybe 20 deaf dogs, not a ton, and you could Skype with me, and pretty much it's all doing remote collar training with hand signals and food. Next.
Thanks. I've been making it a fun place to be. We'll need to give her time.
Awesome. Awesome, Lene. Cool.
I saw group play sessions at a couple of facilities. What should I have seen, not seen?
All depends on what exactly they were doing. What's the ratio? So was there 20 dogs for one handler? That's not enough. Were the dogs allowed to, was there any humping behavior? Was there any humping behavior going on? Was there any play fighting going on? Did it look like dogs were piling up on one dog? In our sessions, that's not what we do. That's not socialization, that's play. So socialization, we show it on our Periscope channel. We show socialization, which is more like a cocktail party. I'm not against play, but for a lot of the dogs we work with, that could be just a really bad thing. A lot of dogs don't like that. So all depends on we offer socialization classes. Next.
I have a Welsh Terrier who has dog aggression towards certain dogs. Any tips? I have a plastic prong.
So, first of all, get rid of your plastic prong and get a real prong. Get yourself, a metal prong collar. You probably want to remote collar train the dog. There's no one tip on how to fix aggression other than you're going to have to punish the act of aggression. But what I want you to do is also do proactive stuff. Train your dog. Train your dog on all the obedience, not casually, but train your dog on all the obedience. Put your dog into a lot of structure, so no free roaming. Crate your dog at night. Crate your dog when you're not home. Cut down on all your affection right now. But the bottom line is, when the dog starts even thinking about being aggressive, it has to be punished. We always recommend remote collars because that's going to give you the quickest, most effective, easiest conversation. Next.
My cousin's Jack Russell always peed and vomited when excited.
Wow.
Excited for Gary Wilkes' seminar this weekend.
Awesome, yeah.
Hey, Heather. And I'm frozen.
Okay. So I think it was a YouTube one. My 14-week-old German Shepherd runs out the door when I put his leash on. When I walk with him alone, he doesn't pull on leash. Your 14-week-old German Shepherd, what you want to do is the leash gets put on, the leash gets put on prior to coming out. Make your dog, sit at the threshold, and if your dog rushes out, correct it. Don't let your dog rush out the front door. But the leash should be on your dog at all times. So, I don't know why we're having software problems at all. at all tonight. Yep. A 12-year-old wants to eat same food 2 days. You just don't let your, it's possible that your dog just isn't hungry anymore as it used to be. Does that make sense? Your dog just might not be as hungry as much as it used to be. So your dog just might be losing its appetite. So what I would do with it, I would have your dog put the food down for 15 minutes in the morning, put your food down for 15 minutes at night. And then what I would do is take the food away. So we lost all the questions. So now we're back to square one. So if you asked a question in the last 10 minutes, you have to ask it again. Our software froze up. Apologies.
Sorry about that. Technical
difficulties. I remember someone was like, "Do you offer dog training licensing?" There is no dog training. In this country at all. People offer. They say they can give you a certificate, but there's no national test. I'm not a licensed dog trainer. There actually is really no such thing. The bottom line is I can care less about a test somebody took. Hand them a leash, let me see them work a dog. That's the true test. We're talking about live animals. You know, you can go to a dog training school and they can give you a certificate. That has zero meaning in my life. I can care less about somebody's certificate. Show me how you work a dog. We're talking about a dog. So, you know, you get a lot of people, they've got, you know, master's degrees, bachelor's degrees in animal behavior. Good for you. Wonderful. That's all great in theory. Here's the leash. My dog is being reactive. Show me what to do. Right now, show me what to do. Like tonight, show me what to do. So that's the kind of thing that's what matters. So when you start working with thousands and thousands of dogs, experience will always out-trump smarts every time. Every time. I can care less how much knowledge you have. Show me the work. So therefore, to me, there's a lot of like, there's no national test. And the tests that they do have are all based on pure positive, which is not dog training. You know, that's not dog training. So to me, that's just like, great, you can teach your dog how to do stuff. That actually is important, but can you get your dog to not do something? I was under the impression that you needed to say you were a true trainer. I don't understand what a true trainer is. What does a true trainer mean? What's a true trainer? I've never heard that before. I'm a dog trainer. I own a dog training company. You know? Anybody can say they're a dog trainer. Anybody can put up a sign saying they're a dog trainer. There's no certification. Nope. So certification, you don't need a certificate. The only people, I've trained over 4,000 dogs, the only people that have ever asked me if I was accredited dog trainer are other dog trainers trying to shame me. I'm not saying you're doing that, but literally, none of my clients have ever asked, you know, me at all. Why? Because we get good results. Who cares? Who cares? It's all results. Dog training is a results-oriented business, and that's what it is. That's all it is. And you always get people that are, like, oh yeah, you know, I'm a certified dog trainer. Good for you. How come you don't have any videos on your website or on your Facebook page? You must suck. Like, why would you not want to have helpful videos? Like, there's no big secret to dog training. Everybody's got a video camera. So you know, that's the thing. Next.
Dog should eat only around 2-3% of its body weight, I think.
I don't know. I don't know what the recipe is. I don't know. Well, I just look at my dogs and make sure they're lean and in good shape, and I keep them active. Next.
In regards to your Instagram, love your daily story videos.
Oh, thank you. I got a fan. Told you. Next.
You got one fan.
I know you're not, Lucy, I know you're not shaming me. That wasn't directed to you at all. Or you wouldn't have heard those comments because you would have been banned. I ban people. You know, I ban people. Why? Because this is a dictatorship. It's the way it is. My channel.
Punish humping objects?
Yeah, I would. You know what I mean? You know, I would. I would absolutely punish it. We use a dressage whip for humping, or we use a remote collar. Dressage whip's great for humping. You know what a dressage whip is? Just dressage. We use one that's about 50 inches tall with an 8-inch drop. We use them in our socialization. Dog starts humping something, quick crack on the ass. You know, dog can end up getting into a deathmatch dog fight if it doesn't stop humping. Plus, it's really rude and impolite. Next.
Dog sees stray cat, correct with e-collar on 80 when I see intent, redirects onto me.
Ernesto, muzzle the dog, redirection is a choice, muzzle the dog, and then work the dog through it. Next. Linda does have the best smile.
Oh, thanks. Yeah.
We went out for lunch today.
We did. We had a nice little date.
That's great. Right. Mm-hmm. Was good, huh?
Yeah. We went to Target, too.
Right.
Who I'd rather be in the car with someone who's 16 and got their license or 40 and never got their license?
Well, Harrison, depending how long the 40-year-old has been driving. So the 40-year-old just got into a car for the first time. I'm not sure. Probably still the 40-year-old, but I don't know. Next.
What kind of insurance do you have? Do you need to be bonded?
Sarah, I've got so much insurance. It's incredible. I've got dog in transit insurance, liability insurance, workman's comp insurance. I've got health insurance. I've got loss of business insurance. We've got liability. I've got endless amounts of insurance. I've got a humongous, humongous policy because I travel so much. I've got commercial vehicle insurance. My seminars are insured. My travel is insured. If my employees use their car to run an errand while they're on the clock, it falls underneath my insurance. I mean, we got so many years. So many different types of insurance. Next. To start insurance wise, I would just get the ICP basic insurance. Next.
My mini e-collar dies after using for only one day. Is that normal?
Your battery might be going down unless you're using it on vibrate mode a lot or you're using it all the time. But if you're using it on vibrate mode a lot, yes, it probably can. It probably can die. Just recharge it every night. Next.
Thank you for helping me. You were great.
Oh, awesome, Mark.
You got some fans.
Oh, thanks, guys. I appreciate it. It's always nice to hear positive feedback.
Started following your info, changed my life. Now have people asking me for dog training.
Oh, Eric Goodman, nice. Cool.
Well, hey guys, how's it going? Linda, you look cute.
Oh, hey,
Jeff,
Kim.
You look good too. Thanks,
great.
Kim.
Great.
Jeff, can I buy your ticket to my place and train my dog to stop whining?
Sure, Harrison. Yeah, I mean, I'd love to get over to Australia. Love it over there. Love it, love it, love it. I'd love to get back for a seminar. Next.
Thanks for all the videos you shared.
Oh, Leanne, you're welcome. You're welcome, Leanne. I appreciate it. You guys are doing great today. Thank you. Thank you. What else? What else is going on?
Nothing coming.
Yeah. We got through all the questions. We probably had to skip a lot. Yep.
My coworker, positive trainer, I told her to watch your video. It could help her, but now I'm blocked.
Oh, well.
Been training for 45 years and still learning. Love your videos.
Yeah, I know. I'm always learning, too. Your coworker, it's really sad because, you know, if you're a dog trainer and you identify with positive reinforcement training, that's really cool. We use that, too. Like, how do you think we train dogs to do stuff? We train them by reinforcing what we wanted through rewards. Do you know what I mean? But you can't stop bad behavior from that. You can't stop it. It's impossible. So, you know, what I would do is I always ask someone this. What I always do is this. If you want to find a good dog trainer, the best way to find a good dog trainer is this. How do you stop a unwanted behavior immediately? Ask him that. Ask him jumping. Jumping's an easy one. Ask them, how do you stop jumping? And if the word punishment isn't in there, they don't know what they're talking about. You have to punish to stop jumping. Training a dog, they'll usually tell you, train the dog to sit. That's not the question. I didn't ask how to train to sit. I asked how to stop jumping. Well, they'll say, turn your back. And I'll say, I don't want to look like I went to an Amsterdam whorehouse. I said, I don't need scratches down my back. I said, how to stop jumping. So it's always all this like bait and switch type stuff. Right? Give me a break. No, how do you stop jumping? You punish it. You make it suck to jump. How do you stop jumping? Leash on the dog, prong collar on the dog, leash on the dog, remote collar on the dog. Dog goes to jump, hard correction, boom, high correction on the remote. There you go. That's how you stop jumping. If they can't answer it that quick and that factual, then they're not a dog trainer, in my opinion. They'll never be able to help you stop an unwanted behavior. That's why people hire dog trainers, to stop unwanted behaviors. Of course we want our dogs to do stuff, but dogs don't go into shelters because they did good behaviors. Dogs get turned into shelters because they couldn't be stopped from unwanted behavior. That's how we make a living. We make a living on that. Next.
Just want to say I don't watch TV. I tune in to Q&A every Monday and Thursday.
Oh, Caroline, thank you so much. Hey. We don't watch TV either.
Are you guys still having cold weather in Rhode Island?
Kim?
Yes.
Kim.
I'm in my snowsuit.
Kim, I was in Florida yesterday at our second house. We just bought a new house in Florida. I'm going to be putting up on Airbnb soon. 85 degrees when I left. Today, we're driving to lunch. 53 and raining. It's going to be June in a couple days.
I'm wearing UGG boots.
Okay, we're in Rhode Island.
UGG boots.
Ain't exactly Alaska. Ridiculous. Next.
I told someone I was a dog trainer and was asked questions. I answered my friends told me to be careful or I could get sued for telling someone what to do and something went wrong.
I don't think so. I think if there was no my financial transaction, good luck with that. Good luck with that. Next.
The reason I went the balanced route, I never get a straight answer.
I know.
My dachshunds can be so stubborn sometimes.
So stubborn, we have to go. It's over an hour. So this is stubborn is code word for lack of motivation. So you need to figure out what your dog's motivation is. You know? That's what you need to do, is figure out your dog's motivation. So what's it going to be? Praise, punishment, combination of both. All right, everybody. Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. If you're brand new to the show, and this seemed a little bit punishment heavy, the reason why it is because you heard a lot of people asking, how do I stop? And then whatever. And the only way you actually can stop a dog from doing something is through punishment. If you actually watch our training videos and if you listen to the full narrative, the full story of how we train dogs, you'll find out that 90% of the time that we reward dogs. And I'm not saying this from a defensive position. I just want to make sure that everyone has the well-rounded picture. And then what we do is we also talk a lot about state of mind. So the dog's state of mind. We want a dog to have a calm state of mind. So we're looking for a dog to do what we want, have a calm state of mind, not do unwanted behavior. Okay. See you later. Thank you so much, honey. Love you.
Bye, soon. Guys. Bye.
And then we also want a dog to have good nutrition and exercise. So that's what we're looking for our dog. So we want everybody to be working on all of those things when it comes to dog training. All right. Thank you so much, Michelle. Great home. It was a whirlwind 3 days of me getting that place ready, though. You know, 25 runs to the store, just filling up this SUV with stuff. But it was good. It was good. Gianna, my sister-in-law, is down there now. Still working on it. Today she put all the outdoor furniture together. The bunk beds are together. We still got about, a bunch more stuff. It's a rental, Airbnb, 3-bedroom, 2-bath, in-ground swimming pool, beautiful home in a great neighborhood in Bradenton, Florida. And it's on Airbnb now, and rates are about anywhere from $42 to $5,000 a month. Yep, that kitchen is stunning. I know. And we had to outfit it with everything. It came with all the stainless steel appliances. Even came with a wine. Wine cooler, wine refrigerator. But we had to get everything for it. Everything's fine. Everything's going great. Thanks, Kim. Yeah, thank you. Wine fridge. Yeah. So it's really nice. Really nice. Yeah, really nice. So I'll put that up on Facebook just to show, get everybody a link, you know. Bradenton, Florida, Lucy. So Bradenton, Florida. So we're 40 miles southwest of Tampa. 9 miles from the beach. Yeah. Yeah, our Airbnb here, that's great. We've got a two-bedroom cottage right on the back of the property here, and it's booked all the time. But that one we do short-term. That one we'll do is, if that one is a three-day minimum on our property here, Florida's going to be a two-week minimum, and eventually it's going to be a one-month minimum as soon as we get it up and running. But we're going to do a two-week minimum right now. Yeah, it's a great area. Yeah, in Ruskin, yeah, it's a fantastic area. And it's a nice suburb, and it's not deed restricted. There's no HOAs. There's no nonsense we have to deal with. We've got great neighbors. The Gulf water is nothing near like the ocean. Yeah, it's definitely different. Pets, Heather, I think I'm going to, but I need to make a separate pet rider, I think. Because people can be really careless with their pets. They really can. And I'm not even talking about bad behavior. I'm just talking about, like, you know, we just don't need dogs marking the house and anything like that. I'm not sure. Right now, I think we're going to do it, but I might change my mind. Yeah. There's even a separate potty area outside for the dogs. I don't know. I'm not quite sure. So we'll see. Right now it's advertised. So I know. Thanks, Michelle. Yeah, that's what we're thinking too. Yeah, I know. Yeah, we got good rules. Or there can be a big financial, you know, it's like smoking. We got a huge, you can't smoke on the property or in the property. You know, we could do it on a case by case basis, but how am I going to know? You know what I mean? How am I going to know? So you don't know. You know, people lie. You know, people say, oh, you know, people that they'll be like, oh, it's a service dog. You know what I mean? And this, I believe in service dogs, but as somebody that's very, very aware of the fraud and service dog and the service dogs, like, you know, so. All right. Take care, everybody. Love you all. Train the trainer is very rigorous. Yeah, it's exhausting. It's 7 days of work, but it'll change your life. It'll change your life. Not just your dog training life. It will change your whole life, like all your life, everything. Even if you don't want to be a dog trainer, it's a big life wake up call. 7 days, 9.5 hours a day. It's intense. It's mentally exhausting, but boy. You come out the other side, just a whole new person. You really do. You really do. If you choose to. It's all on you. Everybody gets the same information there. Some people don't do anything with it. Wasn't their thing. Nope, no train the trainers in Florida. Nope, everything's in Providence in California. Yeah, you bring your dogs. Yeah, you can bring your dogs. Yep. Yeah. Yeah. You bring your dogs. Yeah, it'd be great to have you there, Lucy. Yeah, bring your dogs. So, all right. Take care, everybody. Let me shut off YouTube. Hey, YouTube, I love you guys.